The Senate bid of disgraced televangelist Apollo Quiboloy, who is facing multiple criminal charges here in the Philippines and in the U.S. Even his own candidacy now being questioned by the head of the Workers and Peasants Party, who is denying ever endorsing his bid. We'll now be speaking with Quiboloy's legal counsel, Attorney Mark Tolentino. Attorney Tolentino, welcome to the program. Thanks for joining us today.
Hey, good morning, Ms. Carmina, and good morning to all the televiewers.
Okay, he has yet to be declared an official candidate and already an issue, this time with his Kona. Why did you put WPP, Attorney Sunny Matula, and the WPP saying they didn't file any nomination, any Kona, for the pastor? Why did you put WPP?
WPP, there is a Kona issued in favor of Pastor Quiboloy.
By whom?
Under the other group, because the WPP is the Workers' Peasants Party. I don't know what is that. Sunny Matula, maybe the other group, or because there is a faction with the two groups, and our group is I am the president of this group, and there is a certification from the COMELEC that we are the legitimate, but we don't want the pastor to be involved in the issue about the party. So maybe the Pastor Quiboloy will run as an independent, so we will not allow that issue, Pastor Quiboloy will be used in that issue about the party. So we will file a proper petition to the COMELEC, but Pastor Quiboloy will run as an independent.
But why did you allow this to happen? You are his lawyer. Why did you allow this to happen? Were you the one who put WPP?
Yes, because there is a legitimate WPP. Matula is the different party, different faction of the WPP, and the WPP with the certification from the COMELEC that we are the legitimate is signed by me, and of course with the authority of the chairman and the secretary general.
Who's the chairman? Who's the secretary general of what you claim is your side of the fence? Go ahead.
The chairman, of course, is Roberto Pascual, and the secretary general is Alvin Ginita.
Okay. But knowing that there were these factions, right, and knowing it would put the pastor in a very precarious situation, why would you even allow that to happen?
Because we believe that the WPP is, the legitimate officers of WPP is under my side, because we are the majority, and there is a certification from the COMELEC that we are the legitimate officers of WPP.
What's the difference what's the difference between putting WPP and running as an independent?
So I think there is no difference. That's why I believe Pastor Quiboloy opted to now run as an independent, but we'll still follow the advocacy of pro-labor, pro-peasants, and of course God-centered legislation. That is the priority and the platform of Pastor Quiboloy.
How long has he been pro-labor?
Of course, he is a pro-labor. Exhibit number one is the Kingdom of Jesus Christ. You can see that he helped the poor, he helped the indigenous people. His advocacy is based on focusing on education.
Help in what way? I haven't seen him. Help in what way? I have not seen him nor heard of him speaking about how he's going to uplift the plight of the Filipino laborer.
We say labor, giving opportunities to the workers. That is the advocacy of Pastor Quiboloy. And you can see under exhibit number one is the KOJC. You can see that members of the KOJC, they have the opportunities to work, especially the indigenous people. They have a plantation in the mountain area in Davao. And you can see the school of Jose Maria Marie College, that his focus, his priority is more on labor in relation to a quality of education.
So if he was able to do that then, as a leader of this group, why would he want to run for senator? He's already, as you said it yourself, he's already been able to do that.
He wants to share this kind of leadership, in the KOJC to the Filipino people. Although Pastor Quiboloy, when we talked 2 weeks ago, he has no decision yet to run. He only decided one day before the last day of the filing. The last day of filing is October 8th, so he decided I think October 7, 6 or 7 o'clock in the evening. So that's the time that he decided to run because he's and he wants to help the he wants to be part of the solution of the many problems to of the Philippines. So that is the focus and the priority of Pastor Kibuloy, and he wants to have a God-centered legislation pro-poor, pro-Filipino. And but his special mention is about the freedom, religious freedom. He wants more protection to all the religion in the Philippines, not only KOJC, including Islam, including Catholic, including Iglesia or all other religion. He wants more protection, and the Philippine government should give more protection to the holy grounds against state elements.
Protection from what? I mean, as I see it, there's already freedom of religion here in the country. We may be a greater part of the country may be Catholics, right? But there are also other religious beliefs, and there is freedom. Precisely why the KOJC exists, correct?
Yes, there is freedom. But it is guaranteed in the Philippine Constitution that religious freedom is inviolable. But we need to give more protection to the holy grounds. We say more protection to the holy grounds, and not just a mere search warrant. They can go enter in a religious ground. So there should be a law that gives more protection to the holy grounds.
How is this not self-serving then?
It is not self-serving because the religious freedom will not the advocacy of Pastor Kibuloy about religious freedom is not only for the benefit of the members of the KOJC but all the Filipino people believing in one God or believing in God. So there should be a more protection to them because you can see about what the experience of KOJC about the 16-day siege in Davao. So he wants that will not happen anymore. So there should be a law more protection to all the religion in the Philippines, not only KOJC.
But you were harboring a fugitive.
He's not a fugitive. He's innocent. He is presumed innocent until proven guilty beyond reasonable doubt. Although I cannot discuss about the details of the case, I am not the assigned lawyer in discussing the case. I'm just a lawyer about the political activities of Pastor Kibuloy, so I cannot discuss in details. But I believe as a lawyer that he is innocent, presumed innocent until proven guilty beyond reasonable doubt.
Attorney Tolentino, how can your client be truthful in serving the Filipino people when he couldn't even be truthful in filing his COC, a very straightforward form like a COC, and yet an issue already? Go ahead.
There is no issue about COC because the one who issued the COC, for example, the CONA, is we believe that we are the legitimate WPP. And of course, the best government agency that has the authority to declare who is the legitimate. Of course, if I say we are the legitimate, it's self-serving. If the Matula group will say that they are the legitimate, they are also self-serving. It's better that the Comelec will be the one to decide who is really the legitimate. Because if you ask me, yes, our group is also legitimate.
Again, so we go back to the first point there, right? You could have put it that he was running as an independent, and we wouldn't be talking right now.
Yes, that's why we will, because we believe that we are the legitimate one. But if they're asking for, if they're questioning that CONA, Pastor Kibuloy can run as an independent. Anyway, there are many parties that are inviting him to be their guest candidate.
You said a while ago that he wasn't really thinking about it. He only made up his mind or made the decision October 7, a day before the deadline of the filing. What was the trigger? What was the thought that finally made up his mind and said, okay, he's going to throw his hat into the ring and he's going to run for senator?
All the people that believes in his advocacy. Those are the number one influential factor in making the decision. So he decided to run as a senator is actually from the clamor of the Filipino people believing in his advocacy.
Clamor from the Filipino people?
Filipino people believing in his advocacy.
Mm. What's your proof that there's such a clamor?
Of course, we cannot. That is my allegation. Of course, if you want other allegations, so I have no obligation to push that to believe in my arguments because we believe that there is a clamor for him to run for senator.
There are news reports as well that there is the platform that he's running on is a platform of religious freedom. We discussed
that is number one. That is the number one about religious freedom, but of course there are many. Number two platform of Pastor Quiboloy is zero corruption. Okay, the exhibit number one is KOJC. There is no corruption in KOJC. You can see the big dome, the biggest dome in the world. You can see the discipline of all the members of the KOJC. So you can see what kind of leader is Pastor Quiboloy, and he wants that his kind of leadership in the KOJC. He wants to share it to the entire Filipino people as a senator.
So again, back to the religious freedom. How much more freedom does he want to have? He was able to build the KOJC from the ground up, and yet he wants more religious freedom. In what way?
We say religious freedom, protection to the holy grounds. We say
so
protection to the holy grounds. There should be a law. There should be a law that gives more protection to the holy grounds, not only for KOJC but all the religions in the Philippines. There should be a special law that will give more protection to the holy grounds of all the religious institutions.
Why would he opt to run for the Senate himself? He has supporters within the Senate to put forward his advocacy. He need not be the one to run. So
because he loved the Philippines, that's it. For God and for love of country, that is the prime reason why he's running for senator.
How will he be able, if he is declared an official candidate, how will he be able to run for the Senate while facing these charges against him?
Okay,
both here and in the U.S., by the way, go ahead.
The mere fact that he's running for senator, he is very optimistic that all the cases will be resolved as soon as possible. He will be acquitted. So, because I cannot talk in detail about the case because I'm not the lawyer assigned to all those cases. But the mere fact that he ran, it means that he's very optimistic that all the cases will be resolved in his favor.
We're going to have to leave it at that. Attorney Mark Tolentino there, disgraced Pastor Apollo Quiboloy's legal counsel. Thanks for joining us this noon.
You.